안녕하세요. 저희는
동남아시아 남자들입니다.
저거 까먹었어요.
And welcome to yet another long-awaited episode of Ask Lim Bae's, where we answer your questions about Korea. 그래서 오늘 예전처럼 구독자분들의 질문을 일일이 뽑아서 얘기를 하도록 하겠습니다. 자, so today is a very warm, warm July summer day, and Alan and I, we're here in this very lovely little cafe.
Very small, actually.
Very small, very small. There's a lot of these kind of small cafes in Korea, and
it's not a lot of people. It's not really noticeable when we walk past this now.
And the most important thing is we're here to eat the most important dessert of Korean summer.
Ice kacang.
That is... Pingsu. Yes, Pingsu. Or a lot of Singaporeans and Malaysians will call ice kacang.
Okay? ABC. ABC.
What's ABC?
I think it's called ice batu campok.
Oh. So this is Korean ice kacang, if you will have it. And as you can see, I have this little fan here. This is here another very important accessory here in Korea during summer.
But yours is running on battery or is chargeable?
Chargeable, this chargeable. And you can see a lot of people on the street, almost 50% at least on the streets are carrying on this. Take a look. So you see people behind us, they are using their fan too. Look at that, yeah, look at that fan.
Just in case you may wonder, not just girls, actually even guys
are
holding
it.
In office attire, in their suit, they're also holding it.
Oh, look at that, we're just sitting here. Wow, this looks very foreign, right? It looks very not Southeast Asia, right?
Yeah, a little bit like Australia, like that.
Oh, okay, so... Right. So, let's eat up and answer some questions. Okay, for those of you who don't know, okay, Alan, because we haven't done this for a long time.
I have to go and get something.
Okay. And we have coffee to go along with Pingsu. This is like the weirdest combination you can find in Korea. Okay, but anyways, but Koreans never do this. Coffee with Pingsu is damn weird. Okay, because we haven't done this for a very long time, so some of you may not know Alan. Okay, so let me introduce him again. Alan, he's from Malaysia, and he's been here for how long?
2 years.
Two years. And what do you do in Korea?
I'm working in a marketing agency.
Yeah. And what do you intend to do in Korea?
I want to live in Korea.
For how long?
Until I die.
Yes, that's why I get him here to do all my Ask Lim Bae programs, because he has a lot of experience to share about Korea, especially when it comes to working in Korea. Lim Bae don't work, has never worked before. I don't know what the fuck it's like working or what is it like to be in a Korean company. So any such questions about getting a job, about Korean company, how it's like, okay, you guys gotta ask him. So that brings us back to the topic, right? Today, what are we here to do? We're here to answer some of your questions.
Let's take a look. We have questions, right?
Yeah, we have questions this week. Let's take a look. Okay, let's show them the question. Here you are. Okay, first question from Cheryl Toh. I hope I pronounced your name correctly. Cheryl Toh. Can you compile a list of all the makcik that he has personally visited, especially around the area you live? Seriously, he wants to know every makcik that I have been to over the past 3 years.
She's encouraging you to actually write a book, is it?
I'm here for this is my fourth year already. I finished 3 years in Korea. This is my fourth year in Korea already. So Alan, this year, how many years did you finish here?
This is the third year. I entered into the fourth year.
Okay, so I've been to so many places. So if you want to know some of these places, you can check out my playlist. I have a playlist called Korean Food. Just check out, I do cover some of the makcik that I personally visited. You can check out that playlist, okay? Okay, next question. Lee Suk Sia for Alan. Is he going to live in Korea forever?
Yeah, most likely forever. Because I want to be here, I want to become a PR, I want to become a citizen if it's possible.
Oh, okay, so this is very interesting because, see, in order to become a PR and a citizen, and I'm sure you're not getting married here, okay?
Because I don't want to.
How is that possible?
It is actually still possible as long as you have a very stable job like myself. And if I am slightly younger, I can actually apply for F2 visa first. F2 is not permanent resident, F2 is just resident.
But what's the requirement for that visa?
First of all, you need to have a very proper job. And you need to be on a working visa, not student visa. You need to be on a working visa first. Any working visa. As far as I know, the most important working visa that you need to have before becoming a resident or permanent resident, right, is E7. And luckily, I have E7 right now. So
How do you get E7?
Because I applied for a job.
See, that's why Lim Pei can never do what he do. See, that is the
drawback.
Exactly. That is the drawback. See, a lot of people, a lot of you guys, you say you envy me, I don't ever have to work and
but
stuff like that.
You can, but you also can. If you can invest money.
Yeah.
You bring in
but,
money, you show
money. I tried it. Don't go that road. Okay? There's a lot of problem, but I want to talk about this. Don't go that road. Okay? So, Lim Pei may not. Without working, I have freedom and everything, I have money, I don't lack anything, but the drawback is this. I don't get visa.
Yeah, that's
proper visa in many countries that I want to go to.
Did you say that?
I say, who the F cares? I don't care. So basically, I'm a tourist everywhere in the world. So basically, the Seike cuisine, that's the problem. I cannot be like him to try to get a PR here unless I get married.
I want
of course.
To settle down here. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, I can, me and
but getting married is actually the easiest.
Yes.
It's in fact the easiest. If you, I'm not encouraging anyone to go for an arranged marriage. But if you meet someone you like, fall in love, once you get married, I think, if I'm not mistaken, after 18 months, you should be able to, you will be granted a permanent residency.
Oh. Let's eat a little bit first. Show them what it's like. Actually, I really like this mango bingsu because it comes with ice cream. But I guess most of them come with ice cream.
The ice cream is vanilla, right? It looks like vanilla.
But wow, the ice is very wow. This is a lot of mango, man.
Yeah.
It's like 2 inches deep of mango. I haven't reached the bingsu yet. I haven't reached the ice yet. Is that ice?
I think it's ice, right? We can totally do a flip flop. You see.
Wow, this is delicious. This is real mango, it's not the preserved canned type. And you realize you dig so deep and still no ice, right? Oh, got ice not? Where's
the center,
ice?
Center.
Wow, it's very deep. Oh,
center
very deep.
Ice,
wow.
Ice.
Okay. For those of you who don't know, bingsu. Oh, look at that. Look at this. You know how I got this? This eye bag?
Why?
This what is after 6 overnight gaming session. 6 days of about 12 hours gaming. Wow, gave me this. But it's good.
He's very lucky because you don't have to work. In Korea, it's called Peksu.
Peksu.
White hand.
But
white hand.
Anyway, for those of you interested in gaming, check out Star Citizen. Star Citizen is the game to end all games, okay? Shooting, flying, whatever, it's got it all, okay? Okay, that's why if you guys are following on my Instagram, you see I got my whole gaming rig is just incredible. For those of you who want to check out my gaming rig, okay, follow my Instagram. Okay, anyway. Okay, for those of you who don't know, this is called pingsu. What pingsu means? The pingsu. It's called ping is ping in Chinese. Su is sui in Chinese. So it's pingsui. Pingsui, ice water. Okay, it's actually called ice water. That's what pingsu really means. Okay, for those of you who don't know, okay, let's set the camera back. Okay. Our program always very long, huh?
Yeah, we always prolong.
Very long,
yeah, always prolong.
Don't have much memory anymore. Okay, 5 more minutes, we need to end this. Okay, now, what's the next? Okay, what's that? What's the next question?
Have I finished talking about the visa thing? but I opened up the door for your readers
okay,
so they can just further explore on their own.
But for me, it's like if me and Limbu get married, then I'll just get the visa. It's very simple. Just play game for 18 months and suddenly I get visa already. Very simple. Oh, okay. So,
but this is this is your question already.
Okay,
how
is it like dating a Korean?
I'm going to keep quiet.
No. Okay, this is still Lee Suk Sia's question. I suppose Lee Suk Sia is a girl, is a lady, huh?
It sounds like
Miss Lee Suk Sia. Okay, how is it like dating Korean? I don't like to stereotype. I don't like to stereotype people. I would say my Limbu is very unique. And if you guys have been following me and Limbu on our Instagram and on YouTube, you will see that we live a very, very different lifestyle from other people. Okay, we are very happy. Limbu makes me lunch every single day. Every day she cooks delicious things for me. Every day we are together. But why is that so? Because I don't work and she's a nurse, she works shift, and so we have a lot of time together. This is what a lot of regular couples don't have in the first place, no matter if you're Korean or not. Okay, because both of us have the kind of time that nobody else has. So that makes a big difference in our relationship and why I really like her a lot, right? But if you you want to talk about generally, because I mean, admittedly, you know, at 43 years old, I did have other girlfriends of other nationalities before. So I would say, comparatively, Koreans dote on their guys. Koreans girls really dote on their boyfriends and husbands, and they try to show it, okay, in various different ways. I mean, not all Korean girls can cook like Lim Bu. I'm sure as hell I will tell you that not every Korean girl will be not will be like Lim Bu. You know, she cooks great, she takes care of the house and everything. But other Korean girls, maybe they show their appreciation to a man in other ways as well. You know, maybe in their behavior, in how they defend them in verbally and physically and things like that. But that also led to Korean girl. Okay, so that also led to, I would say generally, Korean girls are very possessive and very attention seeking. You need to be able to give a lot of attention, and this is the feedback I hear from a lot of my angmoh friends. So a lot of my angmoh friends actually complain. No, they say, "Wow, I cannot take it. My Korean girlfriend."
They are dating Korean
girls. Yep. And they want so much attention. They don't allow me to go out with other girls. Even if I talk to other girls, they find it very. They don't
jealous.
Like it. They feel jealous, and they want every bit of my free time. You know, I don't have my own time. That's the kind of thing I hear a lot from other people. Like for Lim Pei, I don't care. I don't want my own time. I hope Lim Bu fills out every single inch of my time. Okay, that's how I am. That's why I'm very different, right? So I would say that's in general how it's like. But maybe I should make a dedicated video about that, to talk about what is it like dating a Korean. There goes the very noisy Korean girls. Okay, now, what's the next question?
The next question, let me see. Oh, you're going to answer every question?
Of course.
Yeah, okay, let me see. Please help recommend a good temple stay for someone that don't speak Korean.
So, Lenny Weecher. Recommend a good Korean. Okay, first of all, I've never done a temple stay. I'm Catholic, so.
You don't actually have to be a Buddhist to be there. Because
I know,
you just go there
I
to
just
have
find
like meditation.
I still find it like, you know, spiritually.
You can actually go to templestay.com in Korea.
What's that? Templestay.com.
It's simply
okay. Templestay.com. Have you done it before?
I was about to do it, but
that means you haven't done it before.
But because it's actually very, very hot right now. But one of my very very close colleagues just did it a couple of days ago and he enjoyed it. It's actually not very expensive. Ships Hamanon.
Oh.
It's $140 for 3 days and 2 nights.
Show the website.
The website.
Okay. Oh, but the website looks like it's in Korean. Templestay.com.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Templestay.com.
I don't think they have. Oh, there you go.
Oh, they have a Chinese. They have an
English
version.
Okay, so
here's the website.
Templestay.com.
Okay, so what do you find on templestay.com?
You can actually make reservation because it's actually a network of all the temples available for short-term accommodation across the country. So you can, if you live in Seoul or Busan, anywhere, you can actually just go in here and look for a temple and then make a reservation there.
What do you do in a temple stay?
Basically, I think you meditate. I think last time some of the
Can't you do it at home?
But it's too noisy, what?
My home not noisy, what?
Just is different.
My home very quiet, what?
But if I go and stay in your home while you are playing game, it will be a completely different story, right?
No, but meditation is about the serenity of the heart, what?
I don't know how to answer this question.
It's actually in the mountain.
So meaning to say that you basically have a closer connection to the big nature, and then you get to listen to birds chirping.
Now you also got birds at the cafe.
And then you may need to do some work for the temple, so like yes. Just now where we went.
You have to sweep the floor first. Okay, basically what he's saying is, in a temple stay is a thing that you go to do meditation where there's birds and nature, and then also do housework for the temple. Okay, you can come to my house and do all that any day you like, okay?
You can come to mine,
clean my house, and I'll give you a little corner where you can sit there, face the wall and meditate, alright? Okay?
Penny it's raining.
This is the first rain in like 2 weeks, I think.
I bought a very expensive umbrella.
Whoa, look at it. This is like the first rain in 2 weeks. Yeah. Last weekend it was like what, 39 degrees Celsius.
Actually, it helps, man. It helps, man, because it's been very stuffy for the past few
days. Yeah, 103 degrees Fahrenheit and 39 degrees Celsius last weekend. Look at that.
Wow, it's raining today.
I mean, I haven't been out of house for maybe 8 days straight. This is the first time daytime out of house in 8 days.
You have your temple stay?
That's my temple stay. My home is my temple, my castle, my sanctuary. Okay, so that's all for S. Lim Pei today. I hope you guys found our input to be useful. Can I show the pink suit and us together? Ayo.
Okay, I have to carry this.
Okay, carry. Okay,
I've been eating.
Okay.
Okay, this it's still very cold.
It's still very cold. Okay. So yeah, you guys come to Korea, do check out the Pink Su, right? And yeah, that's all. If you guys have any other questions, just post it in our Facebook, and then next weekend we do this every weekend, okay? Next weekend we will answer your questions again and give you a call. Okay. Thank you guys for leaving your questions this week. I don't know where you guys are from. Maybe Singapore. I see some names sounds very Singaporean or Malaysian. Okay, thank you guys for the questions. So, see you guys next week.